I grew up in Anderson, Indiana, population 70,000 people. I lived on the south side of Anderson in the suburb. We had maybe a quarter of an acre of ground. I didn't grow up on a farm. My mom's cousin had a farm in Alexandria, which is about, I don't know, 12 miles away or so. And I can remember going there for reunions. So we were there two, three, four times. So I didn't know squat about a farm. I was never in a position as a child to lose a crop or potentially lose a crop on my farm. As a child, I never lost a bed. I was never in a combine helping to save somebody's crop like those farmers did for Jerry's crop. But in my 17 years as being a pastor, I know people who've done that, who've been in the combine, helping to save a field, save a crop. After the first service, a few people on their way out told me that they were part of that. They grew up on a farm, and somebody they knew had lost a father or an uncle, and they went to help at the farm. And one gentleman say, "That's my story. Dad died when I was 9. I don't know about farming. But I do know a couple of things. If you can bring up the PowerPoint. I do know a couple of things about farming. And we're getting there, we go. The first one is, you can't harvest a crop before it's ready. Now, at my previous church, and I don't do this very often talking about it, but there was a gentleman there named Wayne who was a farmer, and he grew some of the best sweet corn I'd ever had. But he didn't pick the corn when the ear was 3 inches long, because it wasn't ready yet. It wasn't ripe. It wouldn't have tasted good. And there wouldn't have been as much of it to eat. He waited until it was ripe. And the same thing is true with soybeans or wheat or any other crop. I don't care if it's bananas. You wait until the harvest is ready, until the fruit is ripe. And here's the second thing. When the crop is ready to harvest, you gotta go. You can't wait. You can't leave it in the field. And that's what Jerry's dad was talking about. Boys, we gotta be ready. When the crop is ready, when the harvest is ready, we got to go get it, or else it'll go bad. In our scripture this morning, Jesus is walking around the towns and the hillsides and the farms, and he's sharing the good news of the gospel. He's sharing the good news of the kingdom of God. And Matthew makes the comment that Jesus thought the people were like sheep without a shepherd. We might say they were like people with a ship without a rudder, or a kite without a tail, or a teenager without a smartphone. Kind of lost. And then it says, he had compassion on them. Because he loved them. He kept sharing about the kingdom of God. And then he says this, harvest is great, but the workers are few. So pray to the Lord who's in charge of the harvest, and ask him to send more workers into his fields. Here's the punchline of the whole sermon. You're the workers. You're the workers that someone's been praying for. You need to be in the combine, not the literal combine, but you need to be in the spiritual combine. You get to be the one to help the crop. You get to be the one to share the good news of the kingdom of God. You get to be the one to share your life, to share your story. And most importantly, share God's love. Jesus says the harvest is ready. And he calls us to be the combine. to be workers, to be the reapers. So let's pray. Father, we thank you that there have been people in the fields who have helped with your harvest. And we are proof of that because they harvested us. Now, Father, you call us and tell us it's our turn. You call us to be those, answer prayers for folks. You call us to share your love and share our story. And to harvest the crop that you have out there. Father, give us the grace and the strength to do your will in such a way that we can help in the harvest. Give us the wisdom to share what you want us to share. And give us the grace to do it your way. We pray this in Christ's name. Amen.
Would you please stand soon?
The joy of the Lord.
by this morning's experience and hope to go and tell someone that. Turn around. Most of you know it's coming. And now go through the doors and share God's love with everyone you meet. Amen.